Hospital. I am a consultant to Carl Zeiss Meditech. We recently published an article on PressBeyond with our results in the JRS. This was a retrospective study done in our hospital from June 2015 to 18 with a follow-up of at least 1 year. This is 1 year outcomes, 101 patients, mean age of 51 years, underwent bilateral treatment. And this is the uncorrected distance visual acuity at 12 months in the myopic group, 97% were 20/20 or better. In the hyperopic group, 98% were 20/20 or better. Uncorrected near visual acuity in the myopic group, 89% had a binocular vision of J2 or better. In the hyperopic group, at 12 months, 83% had binocular vision of J2 or better. This is a combined distance and near binocular visual acuity. For myopia, 100% had 20/25 and J5, and 97% had 20/20 and J5. In the hyperopic group, 100% had 20/25 and J5, and 96.8% had 20/20 and J5. This is the mean spherical equivalent refraction of distance and near eyes before and after treatment. In the myopic group, for distance, pre-op it was -3.34, which reduced to +0.13 post-op, and near eyes had -3.39, which was -1.42 post-op. Hyperopic, the distance was +1.71, which reduced to -0.13 post-op, and near eyes had +1.78, which changed to -1.28 post-op. This is the safety in the myopic group. 67% had no change, and 28% had gain of one line or more. In the hyperopic group, 68% there was no change, and 23% had gain of one line or more. This is the change in the higher order and spherical aberration, which showed a significant increase in the post-op higher order corneal aberrations in both groups. And the depth of theoretic depth of field as calculated by the protocol of E et al. The dominant eyes in the hyperopic group showed a depth of field of 0.86 and the non-dominant eye 1.55 diopters. In the myopic group, the dominant eye it was 0.48 and the non-dominant eyes it was 0.16 diopters. Although the theoretic depth of focus achieved was larger in the hyperopic group, near vision outcomes were better in the myopic group at 12 months, the possible reasons being regression of the near eye in the hyperopic group, and no planned overcorrection was applied in the treatment planning of the hyperopic group. Two eyes in the hyperopic group underwent early enhancement for near vision at 3 months. None of the eyes in either group underwent enhancement for distance or near vision at 1 year. This was the post-op patient satisfaction and dysmetopsia scores, and as you can see, the patient's satisfaction was excellent in the myopia and hyperopic group, with almost 98% for distance vision, 99% for intermediate, and 95% for near in the myopic group, and 89% in the hyperopic group. And 100% of them achieved spectacle independence for intermediate vision, and around 97% for distance vision. For near vision, it was 95% in the myopic group and 89% in the hyperopic group. Dysphotopsia score, 95% in the myopic group did not have any dysphotopsia, 92% in the hyperopic group, and 5% in the myopic and 8% had only grade 1 or mild dysphotopsia. We also looked at the reading performance using the Salzburg reading desk, and reading is very important skill for engaging, communicating, and interpreting ideas, and reflects the patient's quality of life. Binocularly, we use the patient's own progressive glasses preoperatively before surgery, and postoperatively without any correction. For near, patients were asked to choose their preferred distance, and for intermediate, a fixed distance of 60 centimeters and 80 centimeters was used, the smallest print size that could be read effectively. Reading speeds of more than 80 words per minute were assessed. This is the minimum threshold for recreational reading. The preferred reading distance increased from 41.8 centimeters to 46.16 centimeters at 3 months post-op. Reading speeds at the near preferred distance, 60 centimeters, 80 centimeters, showed significant improvement compared to the pre-op values recorded with the patient's progressive glasses. Previous publication showed the reading performance following Technis Symphony And the average post-op binocular reading speeds at patient's preferred distance was 109. This appears to be significantly lower when compared to the post-op reading speeds achieved in this study, which was 164 words per minute. I also underwent Presbyon 4 years ago, and Professor Dan Ranstein performed my surgery during a live surgery event. And it was very comfortable. I was mildly hyperopic, and immediately after the procedure, I was able to read very well. In fact, at 1 year post-op, I was almost hematopic in the right eye and myopic by about minus 1.75 diopters in the left eye with the binocular vision of 6.3 and N5, and those are my topographies. My intermediate vision also is excellent, and I have a stereopsis of 60-second arcs uncorrected, and corrected it is 20-second arcs, and a good range of vision from 20 centimeters to 80 centimeters. These are some pre-op and post-op pictures, and I was doing live surgery the very next day and demonstrated a difficult cataract surgery. So Presbyon laser blended vision has excellent safety, efficacy, and stability in the Indian population at 1 year follow-up. It's a well-tolerated modality for simultaneous correction of myopia and hyperopia with presbyopia without inducing significant side effects. The reading speeds evaluated under standardized conditions were significantly better after the surgery compared to patients' glasses, indicating objective improvement in everyday reading ability and better quality of vision. Thank you very much for your time.